Today's fun and frolic is a, what have we got? It is a Washburn designed by Grover Jackson, Washburn Mercury. Right? And it's got this fancy Wilkinson thing on here, which, I don't know, it's just, how could it be right? It's got individual saddle height adjustments, but they're all scrunched to the deck. It's just all set up like ass. There's no way I could be able to play right, but we're gonna do our best and figure out how that little gizmo works. Well, let's get at it. First of all, let's find out if the almighty truss rod actually works.
Well, let's just have a look at the old neck straightness. Big honking frets on this thing. Wow. Big honking frets. I'm somewhat impressed. Well, in the first 5 minutes of this adventure. So right now, the neck is not straight enough. It's close. And how the hell we get in there? Like, they've got that hidden away in there. Maybe I can snuggle a wrench in there, but you can't see what the right wrench is. Did he say there was wrenches in there? Yeah, there's one, the tiny one for something else, but not this one. So I'm gonna guess metric. I don't know, how bad could it be? Pop the neck off, I guess, but anyway. Let's see what happens. Only because it's so hidden. And it looks like somebody ratted it. It looks not good. What do we think fits in there? Is it imperial or is it metric? It would be, sloppy seconds on a metric. Let's try that. That's probably enough. Now I know what it is. I just see something else here. A second. It just really seems sloppy. I don't know, we'll see if it even makes a noise. Seems to. Nice Grover tuners on it too. Not locking tuners, so. We're getting there. Let's just see how we did. That sound it just made. What is going on? Well, I could live with that. Yeah. So let's see what's going on with this wacky thing. There's a trem arm here, but I am really perplexed as to how. Well, it's got that set collar on it. Maybe that's what that silly little wrench is for. And a bunch of other baubles of stuff here. We got that. I have no idea what that's for. Another plastic tensioning collet of some type. Nope, that ain't the wrench for that. What is it the wrench for? Nope, this isn't the wrench for anything. Back to square one. Someone's done a fantastic job of buggering that up. And then this is so tight that the bar won't even slide in. So that's supposed to go there, I believe. And then this slides down in there. And then we decide, right? We decide where it wants to live, something like that. And yeah, this is buggered. Somebody's fucking wreck. And then we give this a little tension so that the bar there. It's really not very good. Try that. I mean, it's a nice trem. Somebody said a screw is stripped, but I don't know. I have to loosen those because those hold those down and those aren't adjusted to the right heights. Oh man, guys, get the right wrench. There is a trick for that. I may have to utilize it. But first of all, we think the neck straightness is good. We don't want, see how that's floaty a little bit? We don't want that kind. So we're gonna, theoretically, drop those posts down. Doesn't look like there's much to do there. Could be not so good. Otherwise, we'll just do it the right way and make it float. I don't think Buddy uses it much. I mean, that's not bad, but, well, did it stop floating now that I've wanged it a few times? No, that's not bad. Could possibly stop there. It's just spring tension at this point. Okay, let's see what happens. Ooh. Okay, so it's got that spring arrangement, which I hate. And like, if you really think that center spring's doing anything, you're wrong. And that's exactly the proof there. If I can pull that out with my fingers, like that, it's just laying in there, guys. These are the only ones that are doing the work. And this one's not tensioned. So we're going to straighten that out. And I'm already noticing that the bridge is not going to go low enough to get some decent string action out of this. So the neck needs a shim. So I'm going to just pop the neck off it and get the strings off and just start over. It's a mess. Okay, right now I'm just going to put a straight edge on this neck. And we will just make it straight because the strings are off. It's right now it's got a big backy bow in it, and that's cool because all the strings are off it. And I could anticipate string tension, but I don't think the gauge of strings that were on this are what I'm putting on it. Let's loosen it a little more. Just make sure it works. Or maybe it doesn't work. I'm just pretending. Well, that'll do it. We'll leave that alone. Now I gotta find a shim. And it wants to be a good one because, like I said, this is all the way to the deck and the strings are still way too high. And we, you see what happened. Somebody decided that they were going to get the string action right, and all these are at the base. They can't do anything for you. So, that's what was wrong with this picture. What have I got? I got this beautiful hardwood veneer, and I know that it's about 22 thousandths of an inch thick. Oh, great. Just when I need my calipers, the battery has died. Imagine that. Anyway, I know that. I was going to measure it just to satisfy my own curiosity, but screw that. It's going to be like that. And with any luck. So seeing as all these are down all the way, what I'd like to have happen, and we can check that with another straight edge after, is top of the frets come right to the top of those. Let's see what it looks like.
if I was a guitar string and I was laying right on the frets and I came across there, I would just kiss that. I think we're going to be okay. If I gotta pop the neck off again, I do, but that's a good start for shim. Let's straighten out the springling ding thing and block this guy off. And I've got all these guys. These are for my buddy at Skyscraper Guitars, right? He made up all these little incremental blocks with all the little serrations, so you can find the Uno one that is going to do exactly what you want it to do. That one's probably a little butch for that. I want to dunk down in a little farther. Oh, and that one's just a little too skinny. I'm losing it. That one, I wish, it's going to be that guy. Okay, we'll push him in there and string it up. Nice. String of choice today is Elixir Nano Web. Wish me luck, folks. I'm gonna string it up, block it off, and we'll try and get the string height set. And hopefully the shim I put in will allow me to actually raise those saddles up that are all down to the bottom and not doing anything they're supposed to do. So nothing here is stripped. Like I said, if that little key, I should just throw it away because it's not the right one. If that little key that they gave this guy was supposed to be this key, well, that's why you'd think things are stripped, because it's not the right key. We're all good. All this works. But I do have to be able to loosen them off. So what that does after you get the string height set, obviously, is that locks it down and also locks this little intonation movement, which is back here. Cool stuff. I like it. See, I'm much more liking this. See, the strings are all rattling off the frets, and these are all down to the bottom, and I loosen them off, and there are no strip screws. Next, like I said, it's not tuned up yet, and it's time to place our little block in there. Where'd you go? Right? Where'd you go? Okay. That's going to live there for a while. This is a little wonky, but that's okay. I have a remedy. Oh! Remember all these little things, you know, that they don't sell at Stumac? They do all kinds of other things. Right? Just remember that. They'll be copying that, right? That's why I have a bunch of them, because they do different things. They don't just stand up and hold up instruments. Okay, so what are we gonna do? Tune it up to bitch. I've got my block in the back. I can get rid of this for now because I'm not gonna use it. And we'll get it tuned up and double check the neck relief and then try and adjust some of these saddles to the right height. Okay, so just to understand it right now, that block, springs are loose, right? Springs are loose. Block is holding this from cocking itself all forward, and it's holding it in the exact spot we'd like it to be. Now we can set up the entire guitar and forget about that till the end, and then we'll tighten in the springs till the block falls out and rock and roll. All right, my guesstimation on neck relief. What do we think, folks? Did we win? Did we lose? Is it going to live? Right now, I would say it needs a little bit of a turn. Not much, though. Maybe
I have fabric cobbled a wrench in the past that'll fit in there. That's 5 millimeters. Let's see. See, it's apparent that I've been down this road before and I took a hex key and ground it off. But it's still like pretty tight in there, boys and girls. I'm thinking that should be enough. Ha-ha! It sort of looks like there's something that resembles intonation. That's sort of important. It's just like, if it doesn't look like there's any intonation, then you need to sort of pretend, right? String height. La-di-da. Okay. It's a Fender scale. We're going to use Fender specs. Right now, it's just really good and low, and I like it. I'm going to be able to actually adjust these to do what they're supposed to do, right? Because they ain't never been doing what they're supposed to do. Is that guy still too tight? The ball end seems to work better. No, that's fine. That's a little fiddly, but let's try that, see what happens. Boing, snap, crackle, pop. Are we winning? Oh, that is just perfect. I'm not even gonna screw around with that. That's okay, so you get the idea, but somehow without the neck shim this would never work because everything was dunked as low as it could go and the string action was still not right. And not to mention that all the individual saddle height adjustments were negated. All right, I'll carry on, get all that going, and then I guess it's intonation for the nation, and then do the spring thing, a ding ding. So now you see the bird saddles are all different heights and they're not all dunked to the bottom. I can't imagine that anyone ever enjoyed, like, this was unplayable, really. I mean, it would have made noise, but you never would have liked anything that it did. You can hear the old Peterson spinning in the background. So the idea is you do the intonation and then all these little guys get locked down and nothing moves or jumps around. And it seems that maybe the guy before me did his job. B string sharp, G string sharp too. Intonation is a fantasy. Okay. Try and set some pickup height here. Oh, too close. Come here, screwdriver. Like that. That was good. That's a little too close. Nice. I'm almost out of this. Could be time for a beer. Gotta cook a chicken. No grilling today. Too miserable out. Summer's gone. We had a week of it. Went away. And once again, just thanking everybody for stretching out and getting the Penny Black CD featuring Russ Graham from Killer Dwarfs, Gino Scarpelli from the famed rock trio, Canadian rock trio Gatto. You know, if you've missed all the music, then it's time to jump in and get one. I'll have the link below, Penny Black. Check it out. Okay, I think I'm okay with this now. I guess we could lock those down now that we've figured that out. And I really would hesitate cranking the shit out of that. It doesn't need much to hold everything in place. There's one thing I noticed, that it looks like a little obtuse when you look at it from this end, right? All the saddle, some of the saddles seem like you know, like bad teeth. Right? When you look at that, like you go, does that can't be right? Well, no, it is right because it's the other side that needs to be right. That's it, boys and squirrels. I'm sorry. Next step, let's crank the springs in, let the block fall out, and quit. As far as I'm concerned, the first fret action is fine. You can usually tell that right away when you play. You pull chords out of tune and it's just difficult to play down there. Alright, removing the block device. This really is not tricky at all, except when the block is in the way of the screwdriver. Right? You can do it, Davey. You can do it. She's not even getting close. Hold on. Success. Where's the thing? I have to retune it a bit, but... pretty good for the first crack. Lube up some contact points right now. PTFE. I used to remember what that meant. Tiny drop of that where every string passes over the saddle. It really stays put. And do the same thing down here. You probably can't see me. Well, maybe you can. Down here at the nut. A couple little drops of this jizz in there, rub it in, rub it on, rub it off. Dean's Bebopaluba, Dean's Tube Lube. Oh, it's Dean Mark, I should have known. All right, folks. Soundtrack music. Oh, look. Thanks for all the support, guys. Patrons, subscribers, Facebook group,
Twitter. We're not so Twittery, but we're still there. Thanks for hanging out, guys. Till next time.